How do I boot from a USB thumb drive? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not signed up for my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, visit askleo.com newsletter and sign up today. So this is a very common question, and unfortunately, I'm not necessarily going to be able to give you a specific answer because the answer actually varies fairly dramatically based on your specific machine and how your machine is configured. That being said, I will give you a few things to look for so that you'll know where to look on your machine for the possibilities. So we'll start with what I call the old school options. In the past, when you had a regular old BIOS, what would happen is you would boot the machine and there would be a small period of time while the machine was booting where you could actually press a key and get it to stop and enter the BIOS configuration. We'll talk about BIOS configuration in a moment, but the other thing that I'm seeing on a number of machines right now is that there are two alternatives. There's one keystroke to enter your BIOS configuration, but there's another keystroke that's often referred to as boot option or boot selection or something like that. If that's present, that could be a direct route to exactly what you're looking for. Insert your USB stick, reboot your machine, press whatever that boot option key is while the machine is booting, and you'll probably be given a list of devices that you can boot from. Select the USB device, and you're good to go. One of the things that's complicated the world in recent years is this concept of UEFI. That is a newer, more powerful replacement for BIOS. Even though we still sometimes call it BIOS, it really is something completely different, the UEFI. The issue is that the UEFI tries to solve basically a gaping security hole. And that simply is that if you could walk up to a machine and you could reboot it, you could boot it into something else and then own the machine. You can get access to everything that's on the machine. UEFI includes something called secure boot. There are varying degrees of security. There are various options associated with this, but the bottom line is that it is possible that your machine could be locked down so tightly that you may not be able to boot from anything other than the internal hard disk. Fortunately, that's not necessarily the case. I really only expect to see that in highly secure or corporate environments where they really don't want you messing with their machines. If you've purchased a machine for yourself, there's usually a way to make this happen. As I mentioned before, very often there's a keystroke you can press as the machine is rebooted. Press that keystroke, and then you enter into UEFI setup. In that setup, then, you can change the order in which the UEFI looks for things to boot from. By default, it's probably checking the hard disk first and then everything else. What we want to do is change that boot order to look for bootable USB devices first before it checks the hard disk. That is a setting that you then end up changing in the UEFI BIOS. Now, if you don't have this opportunity to press a keystroke, there's one other option that may or may not work for you. Let me show you what that is, because there's actually an option through Windows that potentially could let you boot into the UEFI firmware setting. So here we are in Windows 11. I'm going to right-click on the Start button, hover over Restart. I'm going to hold down the Shift key when I click on it. That will cause the system to reboot into essentially a maintenance or an administrative mode that will then allow me to make some choices. So here are the various options. What we're going to click on is Troubleshoot, then Advanced Options, and now you'll see we have some interesting options. There are two that I would point you at. Startup Settings, which may allow you to reboot into the UEFI settings, or literally the UEFI firmware settings option. That then, in theory, would take you directly to the UEFI settings for your machine. It'll reboot into those settings, then allow you to change them. Now, I have to say, theoretically, maybe, all that kind of stuff, because this, again, varies dramatically based on exactly what machine you have and how it's configured. I happen to have both of these options here on my example virtual machine. On some machines, the UEFI option is not there, and you'll have to look for other approaches. If none of these examples that I've provided here work to get you into your UEFI settings, check with your computer's manufacturer. They should be able to tell you exactly what steps you need to take on your specific machine in order to make this happen. Like I said, once you're in the settings, much like BIOS before it, you can then change the boot order. Once you change the boot order, you can then boot from your USB device. Now, there is one caveat I need to throw out here before we call this done, and that is that once you've changed the boot order so that the UEFI is checking USB devices first, if you happen to have a hard disk attached that does not have a bootable operating system on it, some poorly written UEFI systems will stall at that point. They will say, okay, I'm supposed to check the USB devices first. I found a USB hard disk, but there's nothing on it. I don't know what to do. They should, and most systems do, say, okay, there's nothing on it. I'll check another USB device, or I'll actually then finally go onto the hard disk. But just be aware that if USB devices are checked before the internal hard disk, some systems will actually see that as a problem if you have a non-bootable USB hard disk or USB thumb drive attached. Hope that helps get you rebooted off of your thumb drive. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/5356. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.